السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على إمام الأنبياء وسيد الورى، وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين هم آثر الهدى على الدجى، وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر، إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. My respected viewers of DEEN TV, Alhamdulillah, I'm here to do the program on the Islam and us. Insha'Allah, today I would like to talk about Iman and A'mal Salihah. My respected brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has so much love and mahabba for us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the guidance that how can we be successful in this world and in the hereafter. My respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even taught us the dua, the رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. That we should be asking this dua. We make dua, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً, you grant us the goodness, hasana, in this world and also in the hereafter. So my respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also told us that how can we protect ourselves from loss. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the complete surah, Suratul Asr. Over there Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, the Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr. That by the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a qasam with the time, asr, then he's saying, innal insana lafi khusr, indeed the mankind in loss. Mankind is in loss. But who are not in this lost position? إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, except those people have iman, those people who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and they perform good deeds. Also, next two other things afterwards. Inshallah, today I would like to talk about these two points. The how can we protect ourselves from loss? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, if we have a iman and a'mal salihah, if we have a belief and if we carry on doing good deed, if we perform good deed, a'mal salihah, then we can be the successful ones, we can be successful in this world, we can be successful in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, number one thing is iman. The belief, people, mankind, those of them, mankind, whoever has iman, they are the successful one. Also, a'mal salihah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in one ayah, the man amila salihan min dhakarin aw untha wa huwa mu'min falanuhyiyannahu hayatan tayyibah wa lanajziyannahum ajrahum bi ahsani ma kanu ya'malun. So number one thing is iman. Second thing is a'mal salihah. If we perform good deeds, a'mal salihah, then we will be successful. So if whenever we do commit good deeds, if whenever we perform our good deeds, our good deed will be accepted if our good deed meets the three conditions. Number one is iman. When a person will perform good deeds, he has to have iman to be the a'mal to be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without the iman, without the belief, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not reward the person for his a'mal in the akhirah. Those non-believers, they have no iman, they are doing good deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them in this world, but there's no any hissa, there's no any part of the reward in the hereafter. But mu'minun, believers, when they perform good deeds, they will be rewarded in this world, in dunya, also in the akhirah, they will be rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, man amila salihan min dhakarin aw untha wa huwa mu'min. Whoever performs good deed, amal salih, nak amal, and while either he is male or female. The condition is wa huwa mu'min, the person is believers. Meaning, that with iman, if the person perform good deed, either the person is male or female, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving the glad tidings to these people, the Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant the person the hayatan tayyibah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the falanuhyiyannahu hayatan tayyibah. With iman, when a person will perform good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant the person the hayatan tayyibah, good life. Also, وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. The short meaning is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant the person Jannah in the hereafter. So my respected brothers and sisters, so number one thing, our a'mal, our good deeds, if we want to be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we have to have iman. And without iman, the person is not successful. There's no chance of the person to be successful, either in this world or in the hereafter. My respected brothers and sisters, so that's one thing, iman. When a person will make shariq with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never ever forgive the person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, the walladina, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, they qul innama ana basharum mithlukum yuha ilay annama ilahukum ilahum wahid. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, though Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you tell your ummah, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ, that I am a human being like you, يُوحَى إِلَيَّ, the wahi came to me, that أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ, indeed your Lord, your ilah, your ma'bud is one, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو, what's the next message? The فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. If anyone would like to meet his Lord, they want fear the meeting of the Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they have desires to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he has to do فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, he has to do أعمال صالحة, to perform good deed, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا, and do not make shariq anyone with his ibadat. To my respected brothers and sisters, message here from these two ayat, that our a'mal will be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we will be performing good deed with solid iman, also when our a'mal will be free from any shirk. That's one point. Second condition of our a'mal to be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ikhlas. That we have to carry on doing our a'mal. Our a'mal has to be carried out with ikhlas, with sincerity. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pure, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the pure things. If there's anything is not solid, is not pure, only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reject this a'mal. Because Allah is the only one who deserve our ibadat. Anything if we do, we have to do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the a'mal will be accepted, the actions will be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either our salah, if we perform any salah, then our salah has to be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. Our salat, our zakat, our qurbani, sacrifice, Even our life is only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our a'mal will be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we will perform our good deeds with ikhlas, with sincerity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that we have been ordered to do a'mal salihah with ikhlas. Meaning, another word is that our a'mal has to be free from showing off, from riya. Either it is in whatever sense. You know, many times people are doing a'mal salihah, doing good deeds, but they are doing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, there is some intention of pleasing people or gaining praise from people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reject these kind of actions. There are many ahadith Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned. Nearest meaning is there are many qurra, those who used to recite tilawat beautifully, their tilawat will be rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said on the day of judgment, you've done the tilawat to show people or to get praise from people, mahmada or bah, wah, wah, mashallah, to gain these things from people, you've done the tilawat. So mashallah, in this world, in dunya, people said, mashallah, he was a great qari, his voice is so nice, and etc. So you got the praise from people, that's enough. There's nothing to get in this in hereafter, in akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from these kind of things. Many people, salah will be rejected. Many people, donation will be rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of that intention. Because when they prayed salah, when they donated money or wealth, or they have even carried out any form of good deeds without the sincerity, without the ikhlas, then this a'mal will be rejected, actions will be rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my respected brothers and sisters, the second message here is that our a'mal, as-salihah, our good deed has to be performed with sincerity, with ikhlas. That's the second condition of our a'mal salihah being accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third condition is, whenever we'll perform our a'mal salihah, our good deeds, this a'mal salihah has to be carried out according to the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, meaning the ittiba'. The first condition is iman. The a'mal salihah has to be carried out with iman. Second condition was the ikhlas. The a'mal salihah has to be carried out with ikhlas, with sincerity. Third, with ittiba, meaning with ittiba Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our a'mal, our good deeds has to be carried out, to be performed according to the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because all the a'mal we are doing at this in Islam, in Shariat, they has to be done in the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our role model. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give us the guidance, to show us everything in our life. Even Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam even taught people how to go to the toilet, how to clean themselves. Non-Muslim of the time, they used to mock at sahabas. They were people, you are following a prophet who's teaching you how to go to the toilet. Allahu Akbar. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed us and taught us these things. Allahu Akbar. How to even clean ourselves after leaving. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught A to Z, everything. Something Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us with words. Then you do this, you don't do this. There are so many things Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed with actions by doing by himself. This is the complete way of life, Islam. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the book. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent messengers so he can show us practically how to live as a Muslim, how to follow Islam, how to do the things. For example, the salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said mentioned in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered the aqimis salah, you establish salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, muttaqina those alladhina yuqimuna salah. Oh, inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. That on an appointed time we have to pray our salah. You establish salah, Allahu Akbar. But how to pray salah? Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed us practically with demonstration that this is how you pray salah. And we have to follow this. Salah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If anyone prays their salah, anyone prays salah in a different way, in a different method than Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then his salah will not be accepted. For example, the Zuhr salah is 4 rakat. If anyone would like to pray, okay, 4 rakat, or I got energy so I can do more. Imagine 6 rakats for salah, or 5 rakats for salah. Or if anyone, then his salah will not be accepted because this is not the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah said to pray salah. Yes, but Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed us how to pray salah, how many rakat in salah. So this is the thing we have to follow. Even 3 people came to the houses of Azwaj Mutahharat, wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they were talking about the summary of the hadith, long hadith. Summary of the hadith is, and they were talking about Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ibadat, then how much Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when they heard about ibadat of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, worship of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a'mal of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they got surprised. And they said, look, where is the Prophet a'mal? Where is our a'mal? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is forgiven. All his mistake is forgiven. There's no mistake. The math, ufira lahu ma taqaddama min Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has no sin. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is ma'soom, sin-free. And there's no sin of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After this, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam performed so much ibadat. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does so much ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are sinful people. And how much are we doing? So they were talking about this. Then one person decided, there were three people. One person decided, from now on, I will pray whole night. Another person decided, from now on, every day I will fast. Another person decided, I will not marry anyone. I will stay single so I can do more ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was informed about these three people's conversation, then they have decided one person is going to pray whole night. Another person will pray fast every day. Another person decided he's not going to marry, he's going to dedicate his life in ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he get married, then he'll be busy with wives, family, etc. He'll have more responsibilities. So he decided not to do this. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is not the right things. I have more fear than you. I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than you. But still, I pray salah and also I sleep. Meaning, throughout the night, I pray salah, also I sleep. I give right, fulfill the rights of my body. Also, I don't fast every day. I fast one day, I miss one day. Also, I have wives, family, children, everything. So this is the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do so much ibadat. If anyone would like to pray whole night, this is not the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even though it sounds good, the whole night he's going to pray salah. But this is not the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَلِجَسَدِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقٌّ. Your body has right. So you have to follow this method. You give your body rest. You have to also, you do ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night time. Because night time's ibadat is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Same, fasting sounds good. Very good thing if anyone fasts. But he cannot fast every day throughout the year. If he want to fast, then he has to miss days in between. Allahu Akbar. So my respected brothers, I showed this hadith and ayat shows that we have our a'mal will be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when our a'mal will be done, actions will be done, good deeds will be done with iman. Secondly, with ikhlas, with sincerity. Thirdly, when it will be done according to these a'mal saliha, the good deeds will be done according to the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When our a'mal, our good deeds will meet these three conditions, iman, ikhlas, and ittiba'ur rasul, then our a'mal saliha, good deeds will be accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My respected brothers, now question is, Allahu Akbar, we are talking about so much of doing a'mal saliha, but what's the benefit? What's the benefit? What is the benefit? What will get out of this a'mal saliha if we perform good deed? My respected brothers, number one, in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us with good life. As I have mentioned, I have recited the ayah at the beginning. The same verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٍ فَلَنُحْيَيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. If anyone does good deed, a'mal saliha, either his male or female, with iman while he's mu'min, while she's mu'min, then Allah will grant him hayatan tayyibah, good life. And now, what does good life means? Many people might say, okay, good life means I have to have a latest car, or I have to have a nice, beautiful house. I have to have some this and that, good job, Allahu Akbar. I have to be someone who may be highly educated. These things we consider as a good deed. My respected brothers and sisters, in the eyes in the Islam, we don't consider these things as a good life. Rather, when a person will have a contentment is in his heart, he'll have the qana'ah, contentment in his heart, then he will have a good life. We see many people, Allahu Akbar, they have everything, but they are not happy. Will we consider the person has a good life? No, he has so much headache, he can't sleep whole night. Allahu Akbar. Sleepless night goes, whole days goes. He doesn't have time to eat even. He doesn't have time to sleep. Are we going to consider that person's life as a good life? Allahu Akbar. My respected brothers and sisters, when a person will have a contentment, he have a happiness in his heart, then that person will have the good life. They'll consider that he has a good life. That's why we see in many poor people, they are in dunyavi life. We consider them, oh, they are less fortunate. They don't have that much. They don't have maybe good house. They don't drive good car. They don't have luxury things. But they are happy in their life. He is happy in his life. She is happy in her life. Allahu Akbar. This is called a hayatan tayyiba, good life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number one benefit here in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant the person good life, hayatan tayyiba. Also, my respected brothers, we have a concern, especially those people who are around 30, they got married, they got children, they have all the concerns nowadays, what will happen to my children? Either in dini lines, in Islamic life aspect, then okay, well, how they will survive, how they will follow deen, etc. And also in worldly matters as well, how they will survive in their education, house, and etc. They are worried about these things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in ayah, then if anyone perform good deed, follow then have taqwa, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save the person from this kind of worry and concern. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the person's family, offspring, and wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the ayah, in Surah Nisa, ayah number 9, وَلْيَخْشَ الَّذِينَ لَوْ تَرَكُوا مِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّةً ضِعَافًا خَافُوا عَلَيْهِمْ فَلْيَتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَلْيَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا. If a person leave his offspring, family members, and is the fear, concern, what will happen to them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving the prescription, the فَلْيَتَّقُوا اللَّهِ, he should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He should gain taqwa, وَلْيَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا, and should say the truth words straightforward. So that's the one, the benefit, my brothers and sisters. Allah will protect the family members. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant the person the love of people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in ayah in Surah Maryam, over there, then when a person will do iman, have iman and a'mal saliha, he will have love of the creation. The creation will love him, respect him. In the ayah in Surah Maryam, Allah has mentioned. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, finally, at the time of death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the person glad tidings. La takhafu wa la tahzanu, don't fear, don't worry. Also, at the end, in Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the full reward. He'll get everything, whatever he wants. Ma tashtahi anfusuhu, whatever the person will want, he will get these things. Also, finally, in the last, he will see or she will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah. So my respected brothers and sisters, if we carry on doing the a'mal saliha, good deed, with iman, with ikhlas, with sincerity, also according to the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us hayatan tayyiba, good life in this world. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect our family, offspring, and wealth. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us glad tidings at the time of death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the journey of death easy for the person. Finally, the person will have the Jannah. He will see the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, finally, he will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wujuhun yawma idhin nadira ila rabbiha nadira. They will have a bright face by looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to protect our iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to carry on doing good deed, perform good deed with iman, ikhlas, and with the ittiba of Rasul, with belief, with sincerity, and according to the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the jaza. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.